Hello, it's Celia, and I hope you all are having a wonderful day. This is not a reading diary. I have been back at work for 1 week after a 7-week long summer vacation, and it has been really nice, but hectic. It's always hectic to start a new school year. And even though I have been reading, I haven't been the best at documenting that reading. So, yeah, there will be a reading diary soonish. Today, instead, I will be doing a tag. And this is a tag that I first saw at Shelly's channel, and I will leave a link to her and also the creator. And later, I also saw that Noah had done it, so I will leave a link to his channel as well. And this tag is called Your Answers Can't Be Books Tag. So this is a tag about non-bookish things. So let's get started. The first question is, what is something you own way too many of other than books? And to be clear, I do have a lot of books. I don't think I have too many. And the same goes for the two things that I will mention here. I have a lot of them, but I don't have too many, or way too many. The first is, I could say mugs in general because I like mugs, but I am thinking in particular about my collection of Moomin mugs. And yeah, I really love Moomin mugs. They are so good to drink from, and they're nice to look at, and they are colorful and bright, and it's Moomin. And I have a lot of the regular ones. I get the seasonal ones, and I also, once in a while, pre-order some really special ones. I do. And I will leave a clip of my collection here. The other thing that I have quite a bit of is plants, and you can see some of them behind here, but I have a lot of plants in my living room, and there will be more, of course. Number two is, what is something you do for fun that's not reading a book? And something that I really like to do, which I can't do at the moment, is traveling. I love going to new places and also, of course, visiting favorite places. I go to Paris once a year, or I did before the pandemic, but I also go on other trips to other countries. I love visiting cities and get lost in them and see new things and, yeah, just being a city. A thing that I also really like to do that I can do now is walking. And yeah, I don't have a driver license and I don't have a car, so I am walking anyway, not just for fun, but I really like to walk around, and especially along the river. But walking for me is some kind of meditation. I usually bring with me a book though, but the walking itself, I can't walk and read at the same time. And believe me, I have tried. And a third thing that I really like to do is yoga, and I do that every day. Number three is, what is something special or important at your nightstand that is not a book? And I don't have a real nightstand. I have actually a bookshelf, a tiny one. And on that bookshelf, I have a plant. I have my current read, and I have my cell phone. But pretty often I do wake up during the night or in the early morning, and I see that Alberta, the cat, is laying there. Sometimes she's sleeping and sometimes she is staring at me. So I would say Alberta. She is important to me. Number four is, what's something that you buy at a bookstore other than books? And I have to admit that I can be a bit annoyed with certain book chains that, or bookstore chains that have a lot of things that is not book related at all. But I do buy my pens there, my pencils, or like writing things. If I buy a book as a gift, I always get a card, usually a Moomin card, because Moomin. And yeah, I also get these post-it flags that I use when I'm reading. And sometimes when I'm, especially if I'm in another country, out traveling, a new city, I can get some little things that can work as a memory, or like a, yeah, a memory of that bookstore. So I can get a mug or a tote bag and sometimes a t-shirt. Number five, what's a fun gift you received that wasn't a book or a gift card for books? And yeah, I really like to get books and gift cards, of course. But recently I got a t-shirt that made me laugh out loud. And I also like to get concert tickets. For my birthday last year, I got tickets for the Nick Cave and the Bad Seed concert that was supposed to be in Oslo in May. Of course, that didn't happen and it has been cancelled. But yeah, I really like to receive gifts like that as well. Number six, what's a YouTube channel you watch that's not related to books? And I really like to watch videos or channels about living in tiny houses or living in cabins or cottages. And one of my favorites is Isabel Paige. She's a young woman living in the mountains in Washington State, and she has built a tiny house and she tries to live as simple as possible. And she is just this really fantastic free spirit, and she manages to see the beauty in everything, and she's just like this big inspiration. And she also makes food that looks so delicious, and yeah, I really adore her channel. The last question is to tag five BookTubers, and I will tag four because two of those that I want to tag, they don't do tags, so yeah. But I will tag Elin at Lunacia Books, Bert and Sean from Pastory Time, and also Heather from The Soggy Expert. So I hope you will do it because I am really curious. And yeah, that was my answers to you. Your answers can't be books tag. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, ha det!